I'm defeated. I don't know what to say. You know, it's like listening to a phonograph record. You can't answer back, you know. It'll keep on talking and talking and talking and talking and talking. And it is a conversation of the deaf. It is two separate monologues. Nobody is listening to the other, you see. He doesn't listen to Africans. Africans don't listen to him. So there's really no communication. It is a complete breakdown of communications. And that is what Rhodesia is, unfortunately. And perhaps he might someday change his mind and listen to reason, but I don't know.
How could he be reasoned into listening to reason?
You see, I can only be ruled by the past, by what has happened in the past. It is only by the past that I can judge the future, you know. I can only hope that Mr. Smith may be reasoned. But to reason with Mr. Smith, to get Mr. Smith to agree to anything that is an opinion other than his own, would really to put a gun in front of him and say, now think, now this is unfair. You see, this is not reasoning. And I don't think really that anybody can touch Mr. Smith. Perhaps Mrs. Smith, as was suggested, perhaps. But frankly, I'm afraid the man is completely, well, according to what has gone on so far, unreachable. Nobody can reach him. I don't think anybody can.
And you feel there's no communication at the moment between the Africans and his government?
I'm afraid not. I'm afraid there isn't.
And on that point of non-communication, can I ask one last question to the audience, and here we must conclude. At this moment, the British government is going for these mandatory sanctions to try and bring Mr. Smith down, bring him to reason or whatever. How many of you in this audience tonight support Mr. Wilson in doing that? Thank you. How many of you do not?